हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम शिखा सोनी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सागर इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ रिसर्च एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज नेटवर्क थ्योरम व्हिच कम्स अंडर नेटवर्क एनालिसिस. एज प्रीवियसली वी हैव डिस्कस्ड मैनी मेथड्स टू सॉल्व एनी लीनियर नेटवर्क विद डिपेंडेंट एंड इंडिपेंडेंट सोर्सेज. एंड टुडे वी विल सी the part of network theorem. The first theorem will be the Thevenin one, but I will let you know that what is the importance of network theorem, why it is important. So if we see in our house, there are many loads are connected with particular line, correct? So if I talk about load, suppose if I make a circuit, okay, and after making the circuit, if I want to keep changing the load element, then to make a circuit that would deliver proper power to the load is difficult, because every time you'll not be changing the voltage and the current, and the particular amount of voltage drop should happen across the load. So for that matter, we practice to make a equivalent of a big circuit in terms of that if there is a change in the load, so we need not to change the whole circuit, only equivalent circuit can be analyzed. In terms of that, we have a total 5 to 6 theorems. Those are very important. So first one is a Thevenin theorem and superposition theorem, then source transformation theorem, Norton's theorem, derivations of Thevenin and Norton's, and theorems of maximum power transmission. So these all theorems are very, very important. And today we will see Thevenin theorem. So, you know, again, as I told you regarding why Thevenin theorem is important. So it often occurs in practice that a particular element in a circuit is a variable, or that for that we called a load, while other elements are fixed. As a typical example, a household outlet terminal may be connected to different appliances and constituting a variable load. Each time the variable element changed, the entire circuit has to be analyzed all over again. So to avoid this problem, Thevenin theorem provides a technique by which the fixed part of the circuit is replaced by an equivalent circuit. So that was the theory behind it. Like we say that if we have any problem, then we find out the solution. So this was the problem which we face. So we came up with Thevenin theorem. Now we will see what Thevenin theorem says. So Thevenin theorem simplifies the process of solving for the unknown values of voltage and current in a network by reducing the network to an equivalent series circuit connected to any pair of network terminal. Okay, so I would like to give a very, you know, simple definition or statement of a Thevenin theorem, that if we have any circuit in which voltage source is present or current source is present, and if there are elements, those are connected with particular or respective voltage source and current source. So if there is a load present there, so that load the whole circuit can be replaced only by a single Thevenin voltage and load, and that will be the equivalent. Just a second. So I was saying that if there is a linear active circuit present in which a voltage source is connected with the elements and load resistance, then whole network can be reduced and replaced with the Thevenin voltage and Thevenin resistance in series with load resistance. So if we have number of elements present in a circuit, that can only be reduce into the three elements. That will be one voltage source, that is called the Thevenin voltage, and one Thevenin resistance, and one load resistance. And any network with two open terminal can be replaced by a single voltage source and a series resistance connected to the open terminal. A component can be removed to produce the open terminals. Okay, so if RL is connected, if you remove RL, so it will become open terminal, and according to that we can connect any variable load into it. So now we will further move on to the next slide. Okay, so here we have Thevenin's theorem example. Suppose there is a voltage, we can see there is a voltage of 36 volt is connected with series combination of resistor, and there are two more resistors which present in parallel combinations. So what we will do, our very first step for Thevenin theorem reduction is whenever you start solving the circuit, the first approach will be remove RL. So what we will do, we will remove load resistance from the terminal AB, or in the question, if it is given that you have to find out the Thevenin equivalent across particular terminal. So here we have terminal AB, across which we have to find out the Thevenin equivalent. So we have removed RL here. Then after that, what we need to do, we need to find out the value of VTH. Okay. So after removing RL, okay, at this terminal, whatever voltage will be, that will be equivalent to VAB. If it is VAB, so it will be equivalent to V Thevenin. Okay. And then we will apply nodal or mesh analysis and find out the value of VTH. So in my previous videos, whosoever is like watching my video very first time can go backward and see. There are series of videos where I have explained mesh analysis and nodal analysis. So we will apply the analysis and then we will take out the unknown value of particular element. Suppose this is VAB. Now there is no any element present for this particular branch. So whatever voltage will across here, AB, that the same voltage reflect on this node. Okay, so we'll call this VAB. Now we will apply nodal analysis, because I can see that there is a node, okay, and after that there are no any element, and there are the value of resistors already have given, and there is a voltage. So there is also, you know, current flowing there. So what we do in nodal analysis, we write the equation in terms of KCL. So here I can say that if suppose I1 current flowing here, okay, and I2 current and here current, which is zero, because across open terminal, the value of current will be zero. Okay. So now how we will find out the value? There are two things. First, we say that, first we see that how many nodes are present. If only one node is there, so only with two steps it can be taken out the value of VAB. If there are two nodes, then in three steps it can be done. So I can do, I can write the value, I can write the equation of KCL. So if I1 is incoming current, for incoming current, I am taking negative sign, or I can write also that if total current is I1, so from this I1, I2 and I3 is parting. So I1 is equals to I2 plus I3. Okay. Now, I1 minus I2 and I3 is 0. Now, I have to write the equation for I1. So, for I1, how I will write the equation? We know that I1 is leaving this terminal. That means this terminal is bigger than this voltage is bigger than this potential, whatever present here, because current always flows from higher potential to the lower potential. Okay. Now, 36 volt will be at the higher potential than the unknown value of voltage, because current is going from higher to low. And the resistance across is 3 minus VAB, and one reference voltage, as we take the reference voltage ground, and ground is always at 0 potential. VAB minus 0, and the resistance across is 6 is equals to 0. So this is the equation through which we can find out. Okay, now whenever we will find out, we will get the value of VAB. So further we'll go. Minus 3 VAB minus VAB is equals to 0. Now here, 108 minus 4AB is equals to 0. So VAB will be 108 divided by 4. Okay, so it will come around to 27. Okay, now we will calculate further. Third step will be, we will take out the value of RTH. So for taking out the value of RTH, what we do, first step is remove DC voltage, and we will replace it with straight line. Okay, or we will short circuit. And if is there any current source I is present, so it will be replaced by open circuit. Then apply rule of series and parallel combination. Okay. So we will see, like here, I can see that the DC voltage has been replaced by the short circuit. Okay. And connected with the short circuit line. And now we have only 3 ohm and 6 ohm are connected. So now we will see that if there is any current flowing across this. Okay. Suppose, if there is a current which will start from this side, so it will be divided into 2 branches. So of course these 2 combination will be in parallel. Now parallel combination. So the parallel RAB or RTH Thevenin resistance will be 2 ohm. Now, as I have told you that the whole circuit, complex circuit, will be replaced by one Thevenin voltage and one Thevenin resistor, which is series with the load resistor, which was 2 ohm. So this will be the very easiest method to solve Thevenin theorem. There are going to be difficult questions with AC sources that we will see in the very next video. And with that video, we will see how to solve Norton theorem, because Thevenin theorem and Norton theorem somehow convertible, because in Norton theorem, there's a current source which can be replaced by the parallel resistors with the current source. And here we have voltage source in series with resistor. So yeah, definitely we can discuss in the next video. So whatever doubts you have, whatever queries you have, I'm here to resolve. Thank you all to see the video. Thank you.